Hey everyone, today we're going to be learning about the magnet tool in Blender and how we can use it. First of all, we're going to need some objects to play around with. So I'm going to press Shift A to open the Add menu, and then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose Cube. I'm then going to use my Duplicate command, which if you remember is Shift and then D. And that will allow me to duplicate an object. Then I can press G and then X, and that's going to allow me to grab my object and then move it along the X-axis. Then I'll just left click to finish positioning it. I'm going to left click my first object, and I'm going to come up to this here, and you can see there's a little magnet button. You can left click to turn it on and off, or you can also use the Hotkey, Shift and then Tab. Notice how that will turn it on and off as well. Beside the magnet, there's a menu called Snapping, and this is just all the settings for the magnet. You can see there's a collection of different snap targets, and there's also a snap base, which determines how it snaps to said snap target. These ones here are very important for retopology in Blender, but this is out of the scope of today's tutorial, so I'll cover it at a later date. Increment will just mean when we move our object, it's just going to snap it to the Blender grid incrementally. So when I press G and M Y, you'll notice how it is now snapping towards each square on the grid. This of course works in edit mode too. So if I press Tab to go into edit mode, and I'll press 1 on the keyboard to vertex select mode, and I'll left click a vertex, and when I press G and Y, you can notice it's going to snap it in increments to that grid as well. Keep in mind though, if I press Tab to go into edit mode, press A to select everything, press Shift Tab to turn off the magnet, and then press G to move my object in some way. When I press Tab to go back into object mode, and press Shift Tab to turn the magnet back on, and then press G and then X for example, you'll notice how it's going to snap to the grid incrementally relative to the origin. If I wanted to fix this, I could right click, then choose Set Origin, and then Origin to Geometry, as we learned in the previous tutorial. Now we're going to press G and X, and then all we would need to do is press Alt G to return our object to the center of the world, since our location hasn't been applied. And now we're going to press G and X, it'll be back to normal. If you're confused about the origin point, one of the previous tutorials in this series is a dedicated video on that topic. The next one I want to talk about is Vertex. And when I have this selected and then I press G and X, you'll notice that no immediate snapping will be seen. But if I move my mouse over to one of the vertices on this other cube here, you can see it's going to snap to that vertex. But one thing you're noticing though is that it's snapping at the center. And if you remember, when I open this magnet menu, the snap base was set to center. So if we wanted to do it the other way, we could change it to closest. And now when I press G and X, you can see it's going to snap like that, which may be a lot more useful for you. I definitely find myself using this option a lot more than the center option. When you're happy with your magnet placement, you can just left click to save it. Of course, this isn't limited to vertices. You can also do it with edges as well. So I could press G and X, and this way I could snap to any edges I want. Things get a lot more interesting though when we go into edit mode. If I press Tab to go into edit mode now, and I'm still in vertex select mode, which is one on the keyboard. I'm going to left click one of my vertices, and now I can press G to move it. And you can see how I could just snap it to any of these edges here. And I can also set it to face, for example. And now if I press 3 on the keyboard and left click a face and press G, you can see I can line it up with one of these faces here. There's also an option called Edge Center, and when I choose this and press G, you can see it's going to line it up specifically with just the center of the edges, which can be quite handy sometimes. And the last one I want to cover here is the snap base by setting it to active. I'm just going to use the vertex snap target for this example, but essentially what the active will do is it will snap based on the active selection. Remember how we talked about active and not active objects, which are selected? Well, the same thing can happen in edit mode with our selections too. So for example, if I shift left click this vertex and then shift left click it again, this vertex will now be the active vertex because it was the last one selected. That means when I press G, you'll notice that wherever I snap to a vertex, that vertex will be the one which it snaps to. And you can test this because if I was to shift left click this vertex here and then shift left click it again, now you'll notice that this vertex here will be the active one. When I press G and snap it, you can see it's now snapping using that one. So active can be a really handy tool to use as well. But yeah, that just about covers the basics of using the magnet tool in Blender. You can see how this could be really useful when you're modeling. For example, I could left click this vertex here, I'll set it back to closest, and then choose G and X. You can see I could easily overlap a vertex I want to overlap. And also, if I've moved something out of place, I could press G and then X again, and I could line it up with this vertex here. And because I've locked it to that one axis, you'll notice how it's not going to move down and line up directly with it. So that means you can line things up on just one axis, which is really handy. So yeah, we're going to be using this tool a lot in the upcoming tutorials in the series once we get some modeling practice in. If you want to stick around for the rest of this series, make sure to check out the playlist here. We also have a bunch of previous tutorials which will keep your knowledge strong and all the fundamentals for getting really good at 3D modeling in Blender. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.